In case you missed it, the Supreme Court has said it never directed the linking of mobile phone SIMs to Aadhaar. So the information in this tweet by Telecom Minister Ravishankar Prasad is patently false. Indu Malhotra will become India's seventh woman Supreme Court judge. That's only seven in 70 years. It's press reset in Indo-China ties as Prime Minister Modi meets Chinese President Xi Jinping in Wuhan. What to expect? And everywhere you look, there's a superhero. Avengers Infinity War is here. What do fans have to say?
It's Friday, April 27th.
In the 70th year of India's independence, the Supreme Court will get its seventh woman judge. Senior advocate Indu Malhotra also has the distinction of becoming the first woman to be directly appointed to the Supreme Court from the bar. Let's look at the near absence of gender diversity in the judiciary in numbers. Women judges make up a mere 10% of the higher judiciary. Eight states don't have a single woman judge, not one. You would think the lower judiciary fares better. No. Of the 15,959 judges in lower judiciary across India, a whopping 11,397 are male judges. Women account for only a little over 27%. This study by Vidhi Center for Legal Policy cites instances of outright bias, quoting prominent judges and lawyers. The former Delhi High Court Chief Justice A.P. Shah described how a woman lawyer he had recommended for judgeship was rejected on the grounds that she was rude, though he believes similar behavior exhibited by a male lawyer would not have been judged as harshly. We asked India's first woman Supreme Court judge what she thought of the gender disparity.
I have opened the door. I am the first to be appointed to the Supreme Court. First woman to be appointed to the Supreme Court. It is not because there is scarcity for competent women to be appointed to the Supreme Court. There are competent persons, women also, who can be considered and appointed as judges of the Supreme Court. It is for the executive to do it.
Meanwhile, the second name recommended by the Collegium for appointment to the Supreme Court, that of Justice K.M. Joseph, has not been cleared by the government. It is being alleged that the government is doing so because it was Justice K.M. Joseph who had in April 2016 ruled against the centre in the case of imposing president's rule in Uttarakhand. The government, while sending back Justice Joseph's name, has cited that he lacks the requisite seniority among High Court judges to be elevated to the Supreme Court. Sitting Supreme Court Judge Justice Kurian Joseph, who is part of the Collegium and is set to retire in November, had asked in a letter to the Chief Justice, exhorting him to act, "Is this not a threat to the independence of judiciary? More than anything else, it sends a wrong message to all judges down the line not to cause any displeasure to the executive, lest they should suffer." As leaders of North and South Korea talk, a meeting that China has considerable stake in, Chinese President Xi Jinping will be hosting Prime Minister Narendra Modi in Wuhan today. The two leaders will be meeting in private in what has been described as an informal summit without aides or a preset agenda. Indian and Chinese troops were engaged in a tense standoff for 73 days in the Doklam area after India stopped the construction of a road by the Chinese army. Let's look at the road to reset in ties. Last month, in a departure from India's position on Tibetans in exile, the Indian government had sent out a note to heads of government departments asking them to stay away from events held to mark the Dalai Lama's 60 years in exile, saying it was, quote, a very sensitive time for bilateral relations with China. This move, the Indian Express reports, was first conveyed through diplomatic channels to Beijing as a mark of goodwill to set the ball rolling for a reset in ties with China. China, meanwhile, had endorsed India's demand for including a specific anti-terrorism section in the BRICS declaration. Pakistan-based Lashkar-e-Taiba and Jaish-e-Mohammed were bracketed with global terror groups like the Islamic State. Though some experts have argued this was a mere diplomatic concession and there was no real change in policy. So will the meeting lay the ground for settling key issues like the border dispute? The Hindu quoted analysts as saying China may be gradually shifting its position from managing and shelving the border issue to a fledgling stance of resolving the border dispute. Is there an economic imperative? Top economic planners of both countries have stressed that globalization needs new momentum, and India and China must work together in the face of neo-protectionist tendencies in the United States and Europe. Meanwhile, Chinese official media are calling this meeting to be as significant as the one in 1988 when Chinese leader Deng Xiaoping and then Indian Prime Minister Rajiv Gandhi met. That's Uttar Pradesh Chief Minister Adityanath, clearly losing his cool while addressing crowds gathered at the accident site in Kushinagar. At least 13 children were killed and 8 injured when their school van collided with a train in Uttar Pradesh's Kushinagar district. The accident took place at an unmanned railway crossing. The chief minister said it appears to be the fault of the school van driver, who, he said, was driving with his earphones on. Railway Minister Piyush Goyal had said in September last that all unmanned crossings will be removed within a year. Unmanned crossings account for nearly 35% of rail accidents. The Indian Space Research Organization and railways are working on a pilot project to use its satellite-based system to warn road users of approaching trains through hooters installed at unmanned rail crossings. Oh yes, Avengers Infinity War is here.
I'd say this is probably the biggest film Hollywood has ever created.
This is like the Durga Puja of Marvel.
This is the culmination of around 18 to 19 films which we've been watching over the past 10 years.
I feel like we've been building up to a crescendo.
Ant-Man teased the creation of the Avengers, and the end of the Avengers teased Thanos.
Thor has been defeated by Thanos. A god has been defeated.
Thanos trying to collect the 6 Infinity Stones, which will help him get rid of half the universe.
It's not to attain some power, it's just because he doesn't deem the creatures who are currently living worthy of this universe.
He's a genocidal humanitarian, if that makes sense to you.
Don't judge a film by its graphic novel.
The thing with the comics is you have access to all of these characters that you've created, but with the films, some of the rights are with the different studios.
Because movies give you a bigger treat.
There has been a lot of evolution among these characters itself.
The evolution of Hulk into this thinking, angry superhero.
Black Panther had this transformation over the course of a movie. Iron Man and Thor and Captain America, they had this transformation over the course of 3 movies.
They've sort of realized that idealism is never, you know, never helpful.
And that journey has led them here against Thanos.
There are a lot of superheroes to remember.
Iron Man, Cap, Thor, Hulk, Black Widow.
Scarlet Witch, Vision.
Spider-Man, there's Doctor Strange, there's Black Panther.
This is gonna be a big list.
You have the Guardians.
Star-Lord, Groot.
You have Falcon.
Gamora, Nebula, Drax.
Rocket Raccoon.
Bucky.
War Machine.
Thanos, be careful.
So, what are you doing this weekend? Whatever it may be, meet us back here on Monday.